지난 2월 제주에서는 코로나 이후 3년 만에 제주국제합창축제인 심포지엄이 열렸습니다. 화합을 주제로 열린 이번 축제에는 전 세계 전문합창단이 참여했는데요. 세계적인 지휘자 마이클 베렉과 티세이 하퍼를 비롯해 전 세계 다양한 합창단과 지휘자들의 참여로 풍성하고 아름다운 합창축제가 되었습니다. 그런데 합창축제가 끝나고 난 뒤 미국 미주리 주립대학교에서 인하니 많은 학생들이 한국에 대한 관심이 증가하면서 한국 유학에 대한 문의가 늘어나고 있다고 하는데요. 미주리 주립대합창단은 한국 방문 일정 동안 2024 제주국제합창축제뿐만 아니라 서울 롯데콘서트홀, 인천경제자유구역 세계합창페스티벌, 세계교회음악합창제, 페이스엠 세계합창페스티벌 등 나인웨이 콘서트에 참여하며 활발한 활동을 이어갔습니다. 그런데 합창단원들은 이번 여행이 콘서트에서 실력을 자랑하고 합창단끼리 경쟁하기 위한 것이 아니었다고 합니다. 한국에서 머문 시간 내내 단원들은 경험을 쌓고 추억을 쌓는 시간이었다고 하는데요. 그리고 이들은 집에 돌아가서 한국에서 느낀 것들이 자신들의 인생을 바꿀 만큼 특별했다고 말합니다. 미주리 대학생들이 한국 공연을 준비하는 데는 몇 달간의 헌신과 노력이 필요했습니다. 간단한 대화가 가능하도록 한국어를 배웠고 문화적 공통점과 차이점을 공부했습니다. 특히 단원들은 작년부터 아리랑을 배우고 연습해왔는데요. 이번 공연에서 아리랑을 불렀을 때 객석은 물론 합창 단원들조차 눈물 울터뜨리는 놀라운 일이 일어났습니다. 이스트만은 인터뷰에서 나에게 가장 의미 있었던 곡은 아리랑이었습니다. 아리랑은 한국 민요를 매혹적으로 편곡한 곡이기 때문에 거의 모든 한국인이 이 곡을 알고 있습니다. 이는 한국의 문화와 역사의 중요한 요소입니다. 한국 관객들의 진심 어린 반응을 보고 합창 단원 중 많은 이들이 눈물을 흘릴 정도였습니다. 허친스는 우리는 콘서트가 끝난 후에도 같이 노래를 부르고 춤을 추었습니다. 한국인들과 음악과 노래를 통해 함께 할 수 있다는 것은 제2의 국어를 갖는 것과 같았습니다라며 벅찬 감정을 전했습니다. 자신들의 인생을 바꿀 만큼 특별했던 한국 방문. 이들은 한국에서 느낀 감동과 아름다운 추억을 모아 미주리 주립대학교 합창단의 한국 투어라는 영상을 만들어 공개했습니다.
I know there will be people on this trip that will separate their life into two categories, and that's before they went to South Korea and experienced what they experienced, and then after.
We were just on a plane for 15 hours from Dallas all the way.
It was long.
I experienced something spiritual, I guess. There was no beginning and no end. Time stopped.
We're about to hop on a flight to go to Jeju Island.
Okay. And what's happening then?
We've got a concert tonight, and so we've got a sound check at around 4 or 5, I think.
And then we perform at the opening ceremony.
This is outside right now. We are getting ready to take off. You can see some of the mountains around Seoul.
Teacher Kim and I began discussing possible plans to bring the Missouri State Chorale to South Korea back in 2022.
The audience was super involved and just like super receptive. So that was awesome. You never know, you know, we're halfway around the world. Don't exactly know what we're going to get, but they loved it. So. Mm-hmm.
Our first few concerts, once we all got out to the lobby, the Indonesian choir just started singing. And then it was this huge song and it turned into this sort of like celebration party. And we were all dancing together, all of these people who like, we don't even know each other's languages. And we were all just singing and dancing, having the absolute best time of our lives.
From my viewpoint on stage, I'm kind of at the edge so I can really see the audience really well. And so it's so cool to look out and just see people smiling and singing along during Arirang and just, you know, doing hearts in the audience, and they just love it and they just live for it and they just appreciate it so much. And so we're just so lucky, so blessed to be able to perform for an audience that just lives and breathes music like we do.
After I finished a solo in Mary Had a Baby, I just felt like kind of like a superstar. I can't lie. It was really, really cool to be welcomed like that.
The first time we sang Arirang to a South Korean audience, they like lit up and enjoyed it so much. It seemed, and we're so pleased that we were singing a song that is deeply important.
The Korean people are extremely grateful, and they show their gratitude in a number of ways.
I just feel so welcomed and so accepted by everyone that I've come across.
In our concerts, their applause was just beautiful, not only for us, but for each other and for the other ensembles was really special to witness.
We were walking downtown one night in Jeju and it was raining and we had like our rain jackets on, but no umbrella. And we were waiting for a walk light to turn green. And this couple who had an umbrella, who were just standing there waiting, chatting, looked over and were like, do you want under the umbrella? They offered to just come let us stand under their umbrella in their personal space just because they could and because we didn't have one. I love the energy of the people and I want to embody that and take that with me when I go back.
Korean generosity and willing to help. It's remarkable. I will never forget that, really.
My sense of humanity has grown because just being in, like, just in cultures that are different from my own is just really, really special.
So the second thing that I'm probably going to remember forever is just all of the relationships I've built on this tour, because there were so many people in Corral that I had just never really talked to before this. And I have built such strong friendships with so many people I would have never thought I would ever like have a very deep connection with.
I was so thrilled for our singers and our students to be able to experience choirs from all over the world, to hear the sounds of Estonia, to hear the sounds of Latvia, the sounds certainly of South Korea, the Philippines as well. It was exciting to just have us immediately be immersed in this international experience.
They're different people now after having experienced different cultures, having a broader picture of humanity and realizing that we have more in common with each other all over the world than we don't.
여러분의 소중한 의견을 남겨주세요. 바쁘시더라도 구독과 좋아요 부탁드립니다. 지금까지 단골이시였습니다. 시청해주셔서 감사합니다.